in the Whitney Museum in New York, the Whitney Biennial. And it has us an epigraph. Notarysojack, as Barney Stover used to say, to unlock the mystery of existence. Anybody remember who Barney Stover was?
Mm-mm.
Greatest comic of the 20th century, after Felix the Cat. There are no women artists. There are no men artists. There are only artists who happen to embody or gender one another. When I speak of art, I am art. I am amongst the artists, those who are so-called. Again, I am art. That which I do is art. That which I write, everything I do is poetry. I remain French Surrealist, and therefore, Ainsi Mesdames et Messieurs, Vide Napoli et muori. I revived my dictum after so many years in abeyance. C'est la guerre totale, total assault. Your museums and galleries must open the door to the Maelstrom, which is us. A man walking outside in the pouring rain. Prendre d'osso, faire d'orange. Artists of color, c'est de l'Afrique, c'est de l'Ethiopie, c'est de les Dogons. There is the veracity of art, in the true cradle of civilization, not the Tigris or Euphrates, sorry, it's Africa. But if you would ask the question, what is contemporary art? Ask then Africa, ask the Cameroon, ask the Cine Salon. One must enter the domain of the oneric. Thus, my absence from your midst is my presence. Art, what you call art, is going on beyond your conceptions, au-delà, beyond the walls of your galleries and museums. Art is here where I am. I speak it each day. In turn, it speaks ancient Egyptian, modern Bambara, and Amhara. It speaks in every word André Breton ever wrote. Thus, au contraire, inscribed in the journals of Arshio Gorky, evidenced in the paintings of Gorky and those of Jackson Pollock, it is they who lead the Maelstrom, the siege of the citadel. Avant, avant! Yet, despite all Philistinism, je t'aime, je suis là, I am the grand artist. The cookie monster would agree with me. Répondez, s'il vous plaît. My tall next door neighbor, long lovely legs, I am sure the rocks are happy as she walks on them. Alors, même que je suis encore fatigué, alors, alas, I am not a tsar, so I can't sweep her off her feet. She knows nothing about art. She is one of the tribe of the technophile, digitalized. But there goes art in her, although it knows it not. The unknown, l'inconnu, the nameless one. I do not know her name or station in life, but she goes into a house and emerges therefrom, onto the therefore, past the window in Morgan Hill from time to time. Now I am silent. I recall the grand artiste, pope of us all, Jackson Pollock, once declared he would rather cease talking with human beings altogether in favor of expressing his communique solely in his art of painting. Bravo, I concur. Yet I persist with talk, 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 when I should only write and otherwise keep silence. And disguised, I sat amongst you, and you wrapped yourselves in different webs. Silently, you guarded the rusty keys of the gate. These words could have come from my own mouth, but they did not. They came from the Russian artist turned mystic and pilgrim, Nicholas Rerich, who migrated to the Himalayas to live his life there. For you, who so tenaciously guard the rusty keys to the gates. That's it.
Thank you.